gentlemen, thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Today is Wednesday, September 6th, 2023. I'm heading to my first service call of the day, which is at John F. Kennedy International Airport, Terminal 7. We're going into the secure Terminal 7. We're going to diagnose and test an AO Smith electric water heater. So I was told that parking could be quite interesting. So let's see what happens. This is the first time actually professionally working at JFK Airport. I've been to this airport probably at least 100 times in my lifetime. Traveling, of course. So this is the first time actually working in a terminal. We've actually worked in one of the cargo facility buildings in the past, but that was not in a secure area where you have to take a tool log and you got to check in the day before with your government ID. So it's going to be a first for that. Looking forward to that. I don't know, guys, smash that thumbs up button in advance because you know how I love to entertain, and this should be entertaining and educational. Let's go see what's going on with this AO Smith electric fired water.
This is Jeff.
This is Jeff.
Hi, this is Mike from the Pipe Doctor. I have an appointment at 8 with you at Terminal 7. Excellent. Where do I park? Where do I go?
Okay. That's a good question.
All right. I tried to park at Terminal 7 for employees only. Like, let me see your ID. So, I gave my license to lay pipe. And like, no, you need employee ID. I'm like, employee ID? I'm like, I'm here to do some work in the building. I'm like, nah, bro, park at Terminal 4. I'm like, oh, you mother effer. All right, let's go see what's going on. All right, so we have to go to the second floor of Terminal 4, which means I gotta get back inside there. Wow, this is the first time actually walking into Terminal 4 and not actually going anywhere, which is kind of crazy. We're not going anywhere. We're gonna take the AirTrain, and I've never done that either, so let me take you on a little, on a walk on the Yellow Brick Road here.
There's our AirTran. Let's get on.
Our next stop will be Terminal 5.
Like I'm on that the train simulator program. All right, we're going to Terminal 7, which is right there. We're going to meet our contact, and it's quarter to eight morning. Hopefully, we can verify the issues with this water heater quickly, and head over to our next service call. efficiently and effectively.
All right, here we are. Small little terminal. I don't think I've ever been here before. Who flies here? Oh, ANA. ANA Airlines, Ethiopian, Kuwait. Oh, yeah. I was in this terminal when I flew ANA to Tokyo. Oh, that was an awesome trip. That was an awesome, awesome trip. All right. Let's wait for our contact.
Oh, you mother... I'll take this.
You gotta get the plastic buckle.
I hear ya. Oh, okay, need the parking pass. The parking pass, this. Put the ID away. Alright.
Love me, Grey Goose. That ain't cheap, though. They ripped you off at $2.83.
Everything's expensive in there, isn't it?
Yeah. They got some houses. I gotta fly a Terminal 7 more off. Good, you? Cool. Excellent. Back outside.
But now you're actually on where the runway is. So.
Oh, no way, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
It's like behind the scenes tour.
Take a scenic route if you want. I get paid by the hour.
I'm in no rush, so you take your time.
Yeah, I'm good. So how old is this water here, you know?
I think this water here has been in stock.
Oh yeah? Yeah, you ain't joking, we are on the runway. Love it. All right, here we are. A replacement here, huh? Okay, power's off to it. Alright, we may have to move the cabinets.
Yeah, we have to move the cabinets out of the way.
Alright, DRE-80-100. Let's open her up. I wonder if it's three phase? Eight elements. Yeah, three phase. From, we have to look that up. All right, we opened up the front access panel by unscrewing top and bottom screw, removed the insulating foam that's covering over the nine thermostats and elements. All the thermostats are set to 120. We're all on 120. And
and one of the first things I did, I checked any open lines to ground. So I had to remove the two wires from both sides of the element to ground, and I had open line, so I don't have continuity. I guess we could check the other ones. Let's test all of the other eight and see what they're reading.
Individually tested all nine elements. They're reading around 65 ohms between both terminals. There's open line between each terminal to ground on each. I don't like the way this thermostat's sitting. We may have to do something with that. It's not making contact with the case, the cabinet. It's not sitting well there. It's not sitting nice there. All right, 60 amps. Can't get in there on the other ones. Okay. So they're all on. Let's take some readings. All right, between each terminal of the element, we're getting 465 volts, and our thermostat is set for 120. So let's check another one randomly. Let's check right here, right there, and there.
Yep, same.
Now let's let this heat up.
So, out of nine.
It's odd that you got one on the bottom that is off.
Yeah.
It should be hot down there. It should progress from the top and step down. As the heat reaches, it satisfies going from the top to bottom, basically.
Yeah, it's interesting. So let me just turn the dial a little bit on the thermostat, and let's see if we could, let's see, maybe something is, come on, baby, right there. Okay, so let's turn that to 150. That's my bottom right. I raised to 150, and I still have no voltage.
Okay, that is probably an issue. That thermostat is definitely bad.
Yep. All right, let me crank up my top right. Crank that up to 150 as well, and let's check that. Also, nothing. Now, okay. So out of nine, two are not doing anything. But that won't explain why. Do I have? I guess I could check water temperature right now at a fixture, but that would mean possibly that seven thermostats are bad, or two are bad.
Yeah, I'm not real sure on that. See what you can do as far as the temperature. See what kind of temperature you're getting.
Okay.
If it's really hot right now, I would say just replace all of them.
Gotcha.
Replace the seven.
All right. Let me, because I'm at an airport, and this okay. service is restaurants. Because I'm basically like on runway level. So I'm gonna pop open the relief valve and see what I.
Say, I was gonna say check it from the.
All right.
Yep.
We are at 120 degrees. All right. So we know that this one, this thermostat, even though it's cranked up to 150, still didn't power on the element. So we know that one's bad. Same thing with this one. All the other ones are off. Except for that one. Obviously, it's not going to sense temperature because it's not resting against the tank. So temporarily, I removed L1, L2 going to the thermostat. And we're going to let this run for, I don't know, half hour or so. And see if our temperature's behaving.
All right, power's back on. Let's pop open the relief valve. See what kind of temperature we're working with in here.
So right now we're at 130 degrees, and it is 842. All right, all of them are off except for the one that's disconnected, which is that one. So none of them are reading any power. We can verify that by just taking an amperage reading, and we're not pulling any power at all. All right, and I'll keep this there. Let's keep this there, and we'll know when
power's applied when it starts pulling amperage.
All right, 5 minutes to nine. Let's do a dump again. My thermal couple of my Fluke meter. Yep. So we are good. So final diagnosis, this thermostat, which is not against the case, is improperly seated. This one is no good, that one's no good, but that's not affecting operation of our heater. Just that one. Damn. That is nuts. Prep sink. Look at that. Pretty good. 122. 126. 127. 8. 9. 30. 31. Alright, so we're not going to really go much more higher. Looks like we're good. Good. 133. Almost identical to what it was out of the relief valve. Alright. Well, that was fun and exciting. I love doing something new every day. We had that water heater overheating, and we took care of it. So I hope you smash that thumbs up button and consider subscribing. There's no cost or obligation. Thank you so much for watching. Catch you on the next one.